Double Dragon's Hotel 101 project in Japan secures a CASB rating for sustainability. Hotel 101 Global signed today a deal with engineering firms to ensure its Niseko project will meet eco-efficient operational standards and set a benchmark for sustainability in the Hokkaido region. The hotel under construction is the first to secure the rating, viewed as Japan's leading framework for evaluating the environmental performance of buildings. Back here at home, Mega World nets half a billion pesos from the sale of secondary shares of its real estate investment trust. The M-REIT shares of over 40 million were sold to an unnamed buyer described by Mega World as a reputable long-term institutional investor. The price tag was at 12.30 pesos apiece. This represents 1.5% of M-REIT's total outstanding shares. Proceeds from the block sale will be used to develop M-REIT's development pipeline. Now, finally, for stock market heavyweight BDO, it is raising to 1 peso per share its regular cash dividends on common shares beginning this second quarter. BDO, which reported higher earnings for Q1 just yesterday, says this will be its new dividend policy moving forward. It also announced that anticipated treasury shares from SM Keppel's merger with BDO would be classified as property dividends. BDO is the surviving entity of that merger, still subject to shareholder and regulatory approvals. More corporate stories now. Fresh from its sugar house acquisition, Frutas Holdings is ready to add more brands in its 2024 mergers and acquisition pipeline. It is looking at adding at least two more new brands this year. Lester Hughes firm signed a deal Thursday to acquire the 40-year-old Sugar House Bake Shop for a still undisclosed amount.
We are looking at a number of segments, both food and food ingredient related segments. We are looking at potential targets. We may also look at building them by ourselves. So that's as much as I can disclose at this time. At least another two. I think that's a safe assumption for us.
The legal counsel of expelled Congressman Arnolfo Teves Jr. slams the Philippine Justice Department for alleging a bribe secured Teves' safety in a Timor-Leste prison. Teves, who was arrested in Dili last month, is wanted for murder here in the Philippines in connection with the killing of Negros Oriental Governor Roel de Gamo and nine others. Citing a news report, the DOJ alleged Thursday Teves' son had offered $2,000 to police to ensure his father's safety behind bars. The accusation earned the ire of attorney Ferdinand Topacio. He asserts the DOJ, particularly its head, Jesus Crispin Remulla, should know fully well that they should not use a news report as a basis for such allegation.
DOJ natin na talagang mema eh. Abogado naman siguro si Secretary Remulla. At alam naman niyo po unang-una na ang newspaper reports, ang evidentiary value po niyan ay hearsay po yan. Ibig sabihin, marites po yan. Hindi po ebidensya yan. Yung pong report ay nasa wikang tetum na hindi po official language ng Pilipinas. Ngayon, katawa-tawa po para sa isang opisyal ng gobyerno na nagko-comment na hearsay.